All right, you primitive screwheads, listen up. See this? This is my boomstick!
While making a sawn-off shotgun, you better buy hinges. Yes, that's a hinge. Like you use indoors, you can get it at any supply store. The best thing is that you use hinges that can disconnect easily. Why? So you can disassemble it while traveling so they don't see like a whole frickin' shotgun through the x-rays. These cost like $5 for a pair or something. You can get it everywhere. It's easy.
Aston, what are you doing?
I'm cutting the barrel for the boomstick. If you have leftovers from the piping that you just cut off from your barrels...
The piping.
I like the pipes. Then you have little rings like this, not too big, not too small. Then you can cut them in two and make a cocker out of it.
A cocker?
A cocker. And a trigger! Haha, trigger.
Yes, you're trigger happy, aren't you?
So, choosing materials. For the stock, there's nothing better than wood. Hard wood. No, actually, it's soft wood. Softer than when I see your mom. Cutting the balsa wood, like we call it here, plywood for you American ones. Make always sure that when you carve it, always go with the lining. Because that way you won't risk any injuries.
But those would make awesome bloopers though.
No, I'm not injuring myself for this movie. Only when we get over 9,000 subscribers, I might do that.
How much?
Over 9,000! After carving the wood, you will have two pieces. The piece for the barrel with the handle, and then the piece for the buttstock. Then you combine those two and you have the base in wood of a shotgun. Jinkui!
And this is why this guy shouldn't drink.
You may want to use craft foam to fill up the gaps in between the gun. Like this, like a sandwich. Just fill it up until you have the required thickness. Why am I talking like this again? Because I suddenly decided to be normal. So just fill it up with craft foam. Draw it out in the same shape, like this. Stick it in between with glue. And then just spray paint them out of. To be even cheaper, you can use cardboard to fill in the gaps. To finish it, use duct tape.
Not just any duct tape, but paper duct tape, so you can paint on it.
Yes, that's right, invisible man. So we start with just wrapping it all around, and you go around.
And around.
And around.
And around.
And around.
Watch out for your shirt.
Not drop my shirt. I bet you want to see it, don't you?
Okay, that's gonna get...
Until you have the whole thing duct taped. Then, what you need to do is add...
Da-da-da.
The buttstock. Duct tape that in as well, or glue it to be even more sure. And then, the next step will follow.